Hi, I think I am live. I'm using another device today, so please let me know if everything is okay in the beginning. I'm going to use my phone to see that my... Hold on, I have to do some settings. I have to make sure... There was a problem with the... I see 30 people here. I'm going to fire up... I'm sorry, one, I'm late. Because like I... Okay, I think I'm going to be able to hold this in one place now. Can you all hear me okay? Just excuse me one second. Okay, I'm going to bring my laptop to see if you guys can see me. And that I'm using another system because our if you remember our... Okay, I see a hi from someone, so I guess this is working fine, right? Happy birthday. It's not my birthday. But thank you for the wishes. Okay, ata wala patta patta sanga, can you quickly tell me? Can you all see me? Can you all hear me slightly more clearly than the past chats? Hi, Sucheta. Tell me, can you hear me? Okay. My team here says everything is okay. Awesome. So, believe it or not, today is the 10th session of Let's Sarega with MK. I feel extremely proud of it. Quite honestly, I did not know how long I would be able to do it. I always wanted to do it very consistently. But I think 10 weeks in a row... it's quite a landmark. And with that, we are going to conclude the first module or the first session or the first season of Let's Sarega today by revising everything we have done so far. And from the next week, for two or three sessions in a row, we are going to do What's Sarega with MK, where we are going to cover the theory of the Indian classical music. Okay? Namaste, your voice is like meditation. Thank you so much. I wish there was a way to read my comments. I'm using this device and I'm not able to. I did a test run yesterday, but it did not quite connect the same way it is doing now. Which is all right. We will figure it out as we go. Okay. So, who wants to... Yes, we can see you and we can hear you. Thank you so much for the feedback. Who wants to remind me what we did in the first session? Can you tell me what we did in our first session? Yeah? Okay, now I'm able to see the comments here, which is awesome. Oh, there's a bunch of them. There's 250 of them, and there's 450, 30, 53 of you here. That's awesome. So in the first session, no, we did not do the Alankars. That was the second session, actually. The first session we did, let's know the 12 swars. Okay. So... sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa, Sa. Will you sing with me? Let's do it. Sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa. Sa ni dha pa ma ga re sa. It is easy. It might sound too simple, but there is happiness in simple things also. So I think you should sing this. If you haven't sung it with me yet, sing it now, okay? Sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa. Sa ni dha pa ma ga re sa. Okay, now we are going to work with the vikrut notes, okay? So re ga dha ni and ma are the five accidentals of the notes, and seven shuddh and five, we are going to cover this in more detail in theory, make the 12 notes that we are talking about. Okay, so sa re sa re sa re ga sa re ga sa re ga ma sa re ga ma sa re ga ma pa sa re ga ma pa dha sa re ga ma pa dha sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa. Who remembers that? How many of you actually joined the session after this happened? Quite a few of you, I think. And as I always appeal to all of you, you are my ambassadors. If you like what you are seeing, hearing or learning right now, I want you to take a moment and share this FB Live on your own respective walls or make a watch party out of it. Hey Google, volume 4. Okay, tell me when you have shared it. It's more clear than any previous sessions. Then Vaishali, why are you complaining? This is the best I could do. I've been researching for a week. I did some test runs on this thing and... Okay. Share. Thank you, Jayavans. Thank you, Snehalata. Thank you, Medha. Thank you, Tejashri. No sound. I thought you could hear me. Can the rest of you hear me? Someone said they are not able to hear me. You already shared. Thank you, Gaurav, for already sharing. Vaidehi, thank you. Hema, thank you. And see, there is a direct impact of when you share this. 50 people more here. This 500 people. We started with 4 something. So that's awesome. So let's get back to the... please keep sharing while doing this. So re, ga, dha and ni, they come lower or flatter. And ma goes sharper or goes ahead. Okay. So sa re, sing with me, okay? I hope you're singing. Sa re, yeah, actually I was suffering from flu. I have not been well since the India trip, since the finale actually. The last 2 weeks of my India trip, I had some throat infection, some cold. And when I came here, it became aggravated and I actually had to lay flat for 2 complete days. I've been on medicines, but now I look much better, do I not? Anyways, let's go back to our exercise. We have a lot to cover today, right? So sa re sa re sa re ga sa re ga sa re ga ma sare ga ma sa re ga ma pa sa re ga ma pa dha sa re ga ma pa dha sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa. Now reverse, okay? Sa ni sa ni. Now the comal distances are going to go farther from the sa. Sa ni is right there, sa ni is farther away from sa, remember that. So sa ni sa ni sa ni dha sa ni dha sa ni dha pa sa ni dha pa ma sa ni dha pa ma sa ni dha pa ma ga sa ni dha pa ma ga sa ni dha pa ma ga re sa ni dha pa ma ga re sa ni dha pa ma ga re sa. So that was our first session. Then the subsequent sessions we worked on alankars. So what are alankars? Who can tell me what are alankars? Alankars are these warm-up exercises that you do before you go and pump your iron in the gymnasium. So it is the warm-up exercise which you do before you should do before you actually sing your songs or your music. Okay, so omkar, as I have told you, is one of those very important. Hi Shambhavitai. Shambhavitai Shambhavi Dandekar, who is an awesome Kathak exponent, just popped in to say hi. I'm so happy you are here. So omkar is what you need to do. Okay, close your eyes and let's do our omkar. Sing with me, okay? Hey Google, play the previous track. Do that for about 10-15 minutes. It'll help you a lot. It helps me a lot. Most of my exercises start with about an hour long of omkar. Okay. Start with 10-15 minutes. I know holding one note for a long time is kind of challenging. So you should start with only 10-15 minutes. The best way to do it, instead of checking it whether it's 10-15 minutes or not, put an alarm for 15 minutes, a timer for 15 minutes, and then do your omkar so you're not distracted, okay? Now, the next exercise is alankars. Alankars, as they are defined in the book, have a pattern, but I wanted to simplify it just so it is easy to remember. We've already done it, but for the benefit of people who haven't been able to join us during those, increase what volume? You guys wanted what volume to be increased exactly? The Tanpura volume or my volume? 15 minutes. It's not 15 seconds, Pratima. 15 seconds is too less. Do it for 15 minutes. Can you hear me all right? There's people that say by Tanpura is not... my voice is, I don't know what, but increase the volume is a couple of messages. My volume. Can you hear me now? Is it better? Make it double. Acha, it's that low. Hey Google, volume 3. Okay, how is it now? How is it now? Is it better? Hey Google. Cancel. Hey Google, play Tanpura on B on YouTube. I said something to the effect of hi or something, which is a routine for Google. It tells me the weather and the news of the day. That's the routine I have, and I say hi Google, good morning. Google thought I'm talking to her, but I was talking to all of you guys. So let's get back to Alankars. It's better now? Yes, good. The way I have laid out the Alankars for the simplicity of memorization is, the first Alankar is going to have one note per phrase, second is going to have two, third one is going to have three notes per phrase, fourth one is going to have four, fifth one is going to have five notes per phrase, sixth one six, seventh one has seven notes per phrase. Those are seven basic Alankars we can do. And then we had something, we did that for two sessions, and then we did something called crunching the combos, which is combo Alankars that we are going to cover after this. So let's sing the first Alankar, okay? Sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa sa ni dha pa ma ga re sa. Okay, let's do that again. Sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa sa ni dha pa ma ga re sa. Now we are going to do Alankar number 2, which is two notes per phrase. Okay, so sa re re ga ga ma ma pa pa dha dha ni ni sa. Hey Google, increase the Tanpura by 1.
Sorry, I'm not sure how to help.
Hey Google, increase the volume by 1.
Sa ni ni dha dha pa pa ma ma ga ga re re sa.
Sa अभिनंदन तुमचं यंगर जनरेशन दादा दादा त्यामुळे आपलं अभिजात संगीत लोकांपुढे. आय एम ग्लॅड यू फील द यंगस्टर्स आर कनेक्टेड विथ क्लासिकल म्युझिक बिकॉज ऑफ वॉट आय हॅव बीन डुईंग. It feels nice to read messages like these. So keep sending them if you mean them. That's the reason I get up half well but still want to teach. I've been teaching when I came here, even when I'm sick, because I'm not so sick that I have to rest. I did when I had to. But now I'm almost okay. I cannot step out and do my other work, but I can log on and teach all of you and teach the students here. You guys are very generous. Let's do Alankar number 2 again.
Sa re re ga ga ma ma pa pa dha dha ni ni sa sa ni ni dha dha pa pa ma ma ga ga re re sa.
Ulsters are also super connected because of your teaching. Thank you, Sharwari ji. Now, Alankar number 3. My 4-year daughter sings with you, sir. That's so beautiful, Nisha. Give her a tight hug from me. So, Alankar number 3. Sa re ga re ga ma ga ma pa ma pa dha pa dha ni dha ni sa. Sa ni dha ni dha pa ma pa ma ga ma ga re sa. Let's do that again. Sa re ga re ga ma pa ma pa dha ni sa. Sa ni dha pa dha pa ma ma ga re ga re sa. That is Alankar number 3. Someone wrote Marathit Bola, someone else. So here's a dilemma I have, okay? A bunch of people do not understand Marathi, but a bunch of my Marathi friends do understand English. If there is a bunch of you who cannot understand English, I'm happy to do 2 shorter sessions, one in Marathi and one in English. I'm going to set up a poll to that effect, if that is what is going to make it easier for you, because the intention is to spread Indian classical music as far and wide as possible. So to do that, English usually is understood to more people than just Marathi, and hence I switched to English. Okay, Alankar number 4, here we go. Sa re ga ma re ga ma pa ga ma pa dha ni sa. Sa ni dha pa ma ga re ma ga re sa. That's Alankar number 4. Now Alankar number 5. Sa re ga ma pa re ga ma pa dha ni ma pa dha ni sa. Sa ni dha pa ma ga re pa ma ga re sa. Sharafat Ali sahab ne likha hai, aap hindi mein baat kare. लेकिन ये और एक फिर डिलेमा हो गया कि मराठी में बोलूं, जिसमें ज़्यादातर तादाद मेरा लाइव देखती है, जो शायद अंग्रेज़ी भी समझती है, या हिंदी में बोलूं, जो ज़्यादातर हिंदुस्तानी लोग सुनते हैं, या अंग्रेज़ी में बोलूं, जो मुझे लगता है काफ़ी सारे देश के लोग, जब मैं हिंदुस्तानी बोलता हूँ आई से ईस्ट इंडियंस, एवरीवन फ्रॉम इंडिया, अफगानिस्तान, पाकिस्तान, ईस्टर्न यूरोप, एवरीवन, या अंग्रेजी, द इंग्लिश इज प्रोबेबली व्हाट आई थॉट इज द मोस्ट अंडरस्टूड लैंग्वेज. और वैसे भी देखो तो जब गाना गाने शुरू कर देता हूँ वो तो एक ही बोली में होता है जिसमें होता है. सो आई होप यू ग्रांट मी सम पेशेंस. ओके, नाउ अलंकार नंबर 6. Sa re ga ma pa dha re ga ma pa dha ni ga ma pa dha ni sa. Sa ni dha pa ma ga re dha pa ma ga re sa. Let's do that again. Sa re ga ma pa dha re ga ma pa dha ni ga ma pa dha ni sa. Sa ni dha pa ma ga re dha pa ma ga re sa. That is Alankar number 6. Without getting into more discussion, Alankar number 7. So today's session is probably going to be a little longer. I hope that is okay. Alankar number 7. Sa re ga ma pa dha ni
re ga ma pa dha ni sa, sa ni dha pa ma ga re, ni dha pa ma ga re sa.
I hope you are singing with me, aren't you? Yeah? Yeah? Okay. What was this Alankar again? Oh, someone already typed it. Roshni Jain is typing out Alankars. Good job, Roshni. Good proactivity. So, Alankar number 7 again.
Sa re ga ma pa dha ni, re ga ma pa dha ni sa, sa ni dha pa ma ga re, ni dha pa ma ga re sa.
That is Alankar number 7. Now, we did all these Alankars calling out the notes, which are called as swars. So we did them in swars or sargam. We are going to do these Alankars in aakar also. So Alankar number 1. Alankar number 2. And so forth. You can sing in aakar while I am singing in sargam also, just if you need that marquee to follow, okay? Might be easier. So this is how you would do all your alankars in aakar. Subsequent sessions, we did something called crunching the combos, okay? My 5-year-old daughter never sleeps without your song in her ears. She loves you lots. Amruta, please tell her I love her a lot also. I'm so happy to hear that. You know, it is one thing to be conquering big venues and conferences, but it is also probably as special or a little more special to be a part of someone's life in a meaningful way, life like that. And I feel really grateful to be able to be or do that. I don't think I'm doing anything, quite honestly. I just sing, I just do my thing. But if it has that effect, it just makes me feel it's something that is very humbling, is all I can say. Okay, now we are doing combo. Who can tell me what combo alankars is? Type it out. Tell me what the combo alankars is. We have started our quizzes, by the way. Now we are going to do quiz. What is combo alankar? Combo of one and one. What are combos, I'm asking? When you mix an alankar with another alankar, you have combo alankars. Okay? So, sa, combo of one and one is, what is combo of one and one? Type out, please. Quiz time. Vithal Bhakti is increasing because of your songs. No, it probably just reminds you of your Bhakti. I'm sure it's already there. But I'm happy to know. Alankar one with one, I know that. But tell me what it's going to be. Arpana got it right, but she has only two phrases, which does not count. So type more. At least three phrases. Well, okay, she got it right, so we'll say.
Sa sa re re ga ga ma ma pa pa dha dha ni ni sa 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 ni ni dha dha pa pa ma ma ga ga re re sa sa.
Okay, what is combo of 1 and 2? I want someone to start typing. First three phrases is fine. You don't have to. Good Ashwini, good Purnima, good Geeta, Ranjana, Prajakta, everyone got it right. I'm so happy. Whoever said online once a week teaching does not work, I think this is a proof that it works. Another proof is recordings, because the taste of the pudding is not in the recipe, but it's in the taste itself. So those of you who haven't submitted, by the way, congratulations to all of those. A lot of you have submitted the homework, and I feel very, very happy and proud of all of you. Okay, I know we can do it. We have something very special and unique here. Let's develop it. Okay, and those that have not submitted their homework should start submitting them. Okay, and I think we have a lot of answers for Shrutika, Vaidehi, Sukhada. Hey Google, play the previous track. Saath Dete, I know that is a typo, Sukhada. It must be Saare. Okay, so many of you have the Alankar correct. It's Sa Saare, Re Re Ga, Ga Ga Ma, Ma Ma Pa, Pa Pa Dha, Dha Dha Ni, Ni Ni Sa, Sa Sa Ni, Ni Ni Dha, Dha Dha Pa, Pa Pa Ma, Ma Ma Ga, Ga Ga Re, Re Re Sa. Now combo of, okay, let's do a quiz, because instead of going through all combos serially, I want you to type combo of 2 and 3. Combo of 2 and 3. Chalo type karo combo of 2 and 3. I know, it's typing mistake. Okay, we have the first right answer from Prachi. It is Sa. Sa. Okay, from Arpana, Anil, Vaishali. So 2 and 3. Sa re, sa re ga, re ga, re ga ma, ga ma, ga ma pa, ma pa, ma pa dha, pa dha, pa dha ni, dha ni, dha ni sa, sa ni, dha ni, dha ni, dha pa, ma, pa ma, pa ma ga re, ga re, ga re sa. That's awesome. Now the next question. Combo it's all easy for you, I think. Okay, combo of 4 and 2. Lots of correct answers, lots of. I'm sorry, I can't take all the names. Okay, combo of 4 and 2. In the meantime, I'm going to read the names that have the right answers. Nita, Rajeshri, Gauri, Sonali, Mitali, Pulkita, Purnima, Shri Krishna, Smita, Dr. Vishwas, Padmaja, Pooja. Oh, I have to keep on scrolling. Everybody got the right answers. Priyanka Samuel, you just typed one phrase. We need at least three phrases. Okay, I'll give it to you actually. That's okay. If you got one phrase correct, I know you'll get three phrases correct. So it's Sa Re Ga Ma Sa Re, Re Ga Ma Pa Re Ga, Ga Ma Pa Dha Ga Ma, Ma Pa Dha Ni Ma Pa, Pa Dha Ni Sa Pa Dha, Dha Ni Sa Re Dha Ni, Ni Sa Re Ga Ni Sa. And then I want to pause and tell you, sometimes it might be tricky to understand when to stop. The place you stop is where the second part of the combo reaches the sa. Okay, so the Sare ga ma sare, that sare alankar number 2 needs to resolve because that's the end portion of the combo alankar. So
sare ga ma sare, re ga ma pa re ga, ga ma pa dha ga ma pa dha ni ma pa, pa dha ni sa pa dha, dha ni sa re dha ni, ni sa re ga ni sa.
Okay, now backwards.
Sa ni dha pa sa ni, ni dha pa ma ni dha, dha pa ma ga dha pa, pa ma ga re pa ma ga re sa ma ga, ga re sa ni ga re, re sa ni dha re sa.
Okay, that's 4 and 2. We are going to do, I think we should move on. The beautiful thing about combos and alankars is you can do it in sargam, you can do it in aakar. If you do it slow, it is going to help your alap, aakar alaps. If you do it fast, it is going to help you develop your taans. Okay, so do it in both these ways and you'll be fine. And we are coming to the next, the last section of the Let's Sarega 10 week series, thoughts. So what are thoughts? Tell me. We have discussed this. I want you to tell me what are thoughts. Someone type it out here. Anupreeta, I need to practice more. That's lovely. You know, realizing, even I feel the same way. I need to practice more. And you will feel that way irrespective of how much you practice. Even on bad days, I certainly feel I need to practice more. But even on good days, I feel I want to practice more, because when you practice longer and harder, you start seeing things that you otherwise don't. And once you do, you want to keep on seeing things that are beyond, that you can feel but you cannot see. So please keep practicing. You say when you say it's easy, but when I try to sing it, it's all good. But so Nishida, don't sing it on your own yet. Sing it with my recording. My recording is available on Facebook for you 24 hours whenever you want. So go. You can also save these sessions. Can you? Yeah, I think Facebook allows you to save them and do them. They are also uploaded on YouTube now, on my channel. So I'm sure if you repeat it over and over, you will be able to get it. Okay. Now, thaats are combinations of swaras. Thaats are from where ragas are formed. They are the names of common and famous ragas. Thaats are groups of shuddha and or ashuddha swaras clubbed together to sound melodious. So that's a good one, Shridhar. But I would not say ashuddha. Vikrut is the operating word there. I know you didn't mean it. What are thaats, Prasad? He wrote the names of all the thaats. That's very cunning. Nidhi, there are 10 thaats in Hindustani classical music. Each thaat has different rules and the ragas are divided into these thaats depending on the rules that each thaat follows. That's beautiful. Although my question was a little different. What are thaats? You know, thaats are these supersets or these folders in which similar rags will fit, and these folders are categorized according to different intervals. Okay, all thaats, I might not have said this previously, but all thaats are sampurna, which means, and we'll see what sampurna means in the theory part in What's Sarega with MK. But all thaats have all the seven notes. Okay, So they are different versions of sa re ga ma pa da ni sa. Sometimes the re is komal, sometimes the ga is komal, sometimes both of them are. The 10 such combinations of these are called thaats. Okay. Thaats are actually a lookup table. Okay. They do not exist in music. They are a concept or a lookup table which is used for categorization of ragas. Okay. So that is what thaats are. Now I want, we are back to quiz time. Are you ready? Okay. From the recent one, what notes are komal in thaat aasawari? Chalo, type and send. Pallavi Sen, Sampurna, 7 notes in Aaroh, that is correct. What notes are komal in aasawari? Veena, I am live on Wednesdays at 9 PM Indian time, since you asked me. Ga, dha, ni, anagha, got it right. Re ani dha is not aasawari swati. Tell me what it is. Ga, dha, ni, ga, dha, ni, ga, dha, ni, ga, dha, ni, ga, dha, ni. Good job. Now let's try to sing aasawari. Sa, re, ga, ma, pa, dha, ni, sa. Sa, ni, dha, pa, ma, ga, re, sa. Sa, re, ga, ma, pa, dha, ni, sa. Sa, ni, dha, pa, ma, ga, re, sa. Okay. Now, another one. What is Bhairavi thaat? What notes are komal in Bhairavi thaat? Chalo, type karo. I think I might need a charge on this. Let's see. While you are typing out Bhairavi, we are going to set this up. Okay. Give me 1 minute again. I'm going to step on the side and join you in a minute. Let's see what answers we have. Nisha says everyone wants to learn from you, but it is not possible. But Facebook Live, when you do Facebook Live, well, now everyone can learn from me. This is as authentic as it gets. This is how I teach the elementary kids. And I really hope there is a way to, categorize everyone that is coming here. I would love to teach intermediate and advanced students also. But for now, I think it is necessary to stay focused on trying to do what we are right now, which is Bhairavi thaat. Rega Dhani, a lot of good answers. Okay, so let's revise Bhairavi Thaat.
Sa re ga ma pa da ni sa sa ni da pa ma ga re sa sa ni sa re sa re ga re ga ma ga pa ma pa da pa da ni ga re sa mile sur mera tumhara.
If you remember that one, that is in Bhairavi. So we are doing Bhairavi Thaat.
Sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa sa ni dha pa ma ga re sa.
That is Bhairavi Thaat. Okay, now what? Okay, let me throw a curveball question. I actually did something similar in the MKSM Global Facebook group, and I thought, I reminded myself to do it today here on live also. So if you are not on MKSM Global, join. We have a bunch of activities that go on there. What thought? Let me put a simple one. Hey Google, play the previous track. What thought will you get when you do ma shud in Purvi Thaat? Tell me, chalo. What thought will you get when you do ma shud in Purvi Thaat? Did you hear me? I don't have any answers. Oh, Marva, that's not the right answer. Bhairav, people have the right answer. Okay, so let's revise Bhairav.
Sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa sa ni dha pa ma ga re sa.
That is Bhairav. Now let's make it a little complicated. What thought do you get when you change the ga and ni in Bhairav? Bolo. I'll repeat the question. What thought do you get when you change the ga and ni in Bhairav? I'm looking for your answers here, okay? I have a laptop that I have in my lap. Yes, we have answers pouring in and they are all correct. Shruti, Amruta, Priyanka, Sonia, Biraj Kalyan. That's a beautiful name. Sukanya goes, aasawari nahi hai, because aasawari has reshud, Bhairav has rekomal, right? It is Bhairavi and we have already revised Bhairavi. Now, what thought do you get if you change ma and ni? What will you get when you change ma and ni in Bhairavi? Chalo chalo. What thought do you get when you change ma and ni in Bhairavi? That is the question. Bolo bolo. what thought do you get when you change the ma and ni in Bhairavi? Can you hear me now? Not Marwa, Khamaj. How will you get Khamaj? Not Purvi. Almost Purvi, but not Purvi. Should I give you a hint? The internet breaker thought. I cannot get over that joke. It actually broke the internet quite a few times, that's why. Yes, it is Todi. Okay, it is Todi. So, sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa, from Bhairavi. Sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa, sa ni dha pa ma ga re sa. Sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa, sa ni dha pa ma ga re sa. That is Todi Thaat. Okay, now what thought do you get when you do ga shuddh in Todi? This is a simple one. Bolo. It's difficult. It's not difficult. It will probably take you a little more time to think. Maybe you should just sit with a pen and paper and write it the way we did. And then look at a lookup table. There is a few beautiful schematic diagrams that were done in that MKSM global group. Let me see if I can upload them. Just go to the group and join. They are really, really, I thought, very unique and beautiful. Very creative also. Hey Google, reduce volume by one. Okay. Purvi is the correct answer. Purvi is the correct answer. Purvi is the correct answer. Many people got Purvi. So let's sing Purvi now. Sa re ga, sa re ga ma. That ga changes to sa re ga ma. Got it? Sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa, sa ni dha pa ma. Let's do that again. Sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa, sa ni dha pa ma ga re sa. That's Purvi Thaat. Okay. What thought do you get when you change the ga and ni in Bilawal? Ga and ni in Bilawal. Wow, we went a lot over time today. I need to wrap up. Prajakta, I put the thoughts written in front. That's fine. It's not an exam. It's just a quiz. Okay. Anything that will get you an answer, anything that will help you remind the answer, anything that will help you memorize the answer, anything that will help you deduce the answer, use whatever technique. Okay. Kaafi, that is correct. So sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa. Bilawal becomes sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa, sa ni dha pa ma ga re sa. Okay, let's do that again. Sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa, sa ni dha pa ma ga re sa. That is Kaafi. Okay, now let's revise all the thoughts. be ready at your keyboards and start typing as fast as you can. Ma tivra in Bilawal gets you what thought? Ma tivra in Bilawal gets you what thought? Internet is breaking. I don't know what's going on. I'm sorry. But I see people. Yeah, Kalyan. Now, Re Komal in Kalyan gets you what thought? Re Komal in Kalyan gets you what thought? I'm going to move when I get the first right answer. Prasad gave the first right answer. Marwa. Now, Dha Komal in Marwa gets you what thought? Waiting for the first right answer. Dha Komal in Marwa gets you what thought? Maria. I know that's a typo. Viraj. Dha Komal in Marwa gets you what thought? Purvi. I have a right answer. Again, Prasad gave the first right answer. Asha also gave the answer around the same time. It is Purvi. Akshada also. Ma Shuddh in Purvi gets you what thought? We already did that. Do we have the first right answer? Bhairav. Triveni gave the first right answer, at least the one that I am able to read here. Good. So Bhairav is the thought. Now you do Ga Komal in Purvi, what thought do you get? Ga Komal in Purvi, what thought do you get? Bhairav. Oh, there's a lot of people up. I think you're anticipating the answers now. Okay, now back to Bilawal. Ni Komal in Bilawal gives you what thought? Ni Komal in Bilawal gives you what thought? Ni Komal in Bilawal gives you what thought? Waiting for the first right answer. Khamaj. Yes, the first right answer that I am able to see is from Vidya, Shinoy, and Dhirendra, Triveni, Priyanka, Prajakta, Shrutika, Arpana, Mrinalini, Gopamul, we get told. Oh, she's, her internet is probably lagging. Sanghamitra, Saha. Why is your volume so low? I think it might be because I'm using another device. I don't know whether it, I thought it's clearer today. I hope it is clearer. I'll try to talk slightly louder if that helps. Now, Ga Komal in Khamaj, what thought will you get when you do Ga Komal in Khamaj? Can you hear me now? Ga Komal in Khamaj. Waiting for the first right answer. Amruta has the answer. It is Kaafi. Dha Komal in Kaafi. Dha Komal in Kaafi. Dhirendra got the first answer. It's aasawari. Re Komal in aasawari. Re Komal in aasawari. Wow. what will you get when you do Re Komal in aasawari? Not Kaafi. Bhairavi. So collectively, we were able to answer all the quiz, okay, which is awesome. That concludes our last session of the first module, first season of Let's Sarega with MK. We will be back with Let's Sarega with MK in 2 weeks, but we do not have a break because next week we are going to have What's Sarega with MK. Okay, it's going to be useful. The reason I'm doing all of this is because I want all of us to be on the same plane. I want all of us to understand Indian classical music exactly in the same way, so I'm able to communicate with you a little better. Okay. There is a way of using Alankars in Thaats. So let's pick Bhairav. Alankar number 3. Sa re ga re ga ma ga ma pa ma pa dha pa dha ni dha ni sa sa ni dha ni dha pa dha pa ma ga re ga re sa. So you have 7 Alankars, you have 10 Thaats, you have 70 exercises. Hey Google, play the previous track. Okay, now you have many combos. Combo of 1, you have 5 combos of 1, so 7, 35, so 7 threes are, you have about 300 odd exercises. Let's try combo of 3 and 2 in Bhairav. Okay, sa re ga sa re ga ma re ga ga ma pa ga ma ma pa dha ma pa pa dha ni pa dha dha ni sa dha ni ni sa re ni sa sa ni dha sa ni ni dha pa ni dha dha pa ma dha pa pa ma ga pa ma ma ga re ma ga ga re sa ga re re sa ni re sa. Yeah, so what you could possibly do is, I'm going to give you homework for the next 2 weeks now. Is that okay? Will you promise to do it, please? We will not do something every day. We will do something every alternate day. Okay, so you have 7 deliverables. 7 deliverables. I hope someone writes this down or posts it as a comment later. I will try to also afterwards. I want you to try combo of 3 and 2 in Thaat Kaafi. Okay, let's scrap that. We'll start with something similar. I want something simple. I want you to do Alankar number 3 in Kaafi. Okay, do it tonight. Alankar number 3 in Kaafi. Okay, then you do Alankar number 4 in aasawari. Day after tomorrow, skip tomorrow and the day after tomorrow. We have 7 homeworks that you need to deliver. Okay, then you do Alankar number 5 in Bhairavi. That is 3 homeworks. Okay, then you do combo of Alankars 3 and 2 in Bhairav. That is homework number 4, and you're going to do it alternate days. Okay, that's the 4th homework. Combo Alankar of 3 and 2 in Thaat Bhairav. Now the other homework we are going to do is, can I give you something interesting that we haven't done? Okay, our 5th homework is, I want you to do Aaroh of Thaat Bhairav and Avaroh of Thaat Kaafi. Okay, Aaroh of Thaat Bhairav, Avaroh of Thaat Kaafi. That is 5th homework. 6th homework is, aakar Alankar combo in Bilawal, Shudh Swar in a combo of 4 and 4 in aakar, do it in the fastest but the clearest speed you can. Fastest, clearest aakar combo of 4 and 4 in Thaat Bilawal. So sa re ga ma, so that is what you will do. Fastest, clear recording. Okay, how many did we do? 6 or 7? How many was it? 6 or 7? I lost the count, sorry. Trying to think of the next one, I lost the count. And the last homework, I think I'll give you another one. I think I did 6. Last homework, I want you to do okay. The first half, sa re ga ma, should be Kaafi. The second half should be Purvi. I want you to do Alankar number 1, where sa re ga ma is in Kaafi, Padhanisa is in Purvi. So going up, sa re ga ma, Padhanisa, where sa re ga ma is from Kaafi, Padhanisa is from Purvi. Coming backwards again, Sani Dhapa from Purvi and Magarisa from Kaafi. That is your next homework. Okay. So I don't know if I have time to do Q&A. Okay, let's do quick 5 questions. Quickly. I don't want to leave you guys halfway, since we always do Q&A. Namaste. Namaskar. Mayuri, trust me, you will be able to sing it sooner than later. The reason I gave you this homework is you might have learnt in a notebook, you might have learnt only 10 pages, let's say. But the worth of those 10 pages is more than 10 pages, because you have all the information to construct the homework that I have given. While I might not have directly taught you doing 4 and 4 in aakar, you know how to construct this. That's the beauty, and that's the reason I'm giving you homework. Even if you are not able to sing it, and if you are able to figure it out, that's the first right step towards doing your homework. Okay, don't worry about it at all. Just try your best. That is going to be good enough for me. Your best is all I ask. I don't want you to sing the most correct tune in the world. I don't want you to sing the best tune in the world. I just want you to sing the best tune you can sing sincerely. Okay, that's all I ask. Gay chanda in which rag? This is a Google question, Pragati. Ask Google. What is bol taan? A taan that is done with a bowl is called a bol taan. That has a bowl mounted on it, typically from the bandish, is called a bol taan. Dhoke ala khan. Good work for our brains is what Seema wrote. Yes, it is. My first time, but I'm going to try this. Yes, it was my first time until I thought of it this way. It's brute force. In general, you know, classical music is a very core kind of an art where brute force works very well. So we are trying to exhaust as many possibilities. So when you come to sing, whatever you sing, you already have exercised in some in form of some exercise or else. Too much homework? No, I usually give homework every day. This time I'm giving only an alternate day, so it's not too much homework at all. What's the difference between Bandisha and Rachana? Mayuri Deshmukh, I am not an expert. Well, I'm not an expert of Hindustani music either, but I don't know very much about Carnatic music. So let me get back to you. The way I understand it, very simply put, is bandish serves the purpose that a rachana serves in Carnatic music. So they are similar. Structurally, they are different, but they serve the similar purpose in their own repertoire. Okay. It's easy. When you say we trust you, Tejasri, just trust me then. Sing with me. I'm sure you will do well. See, I'll tell you the intention, the first and primary intention of me teaching the music is I don't want you, well, I hope you do, but I'm not looking for all of you to sing spectacularly well. I want all of you to be able to connect with the music within you. Okay? That is the only thing. If you do, it will be a big gift that you give yourself, that maybe I facilitate giving you. So just worry about whether you are able to connect with the music. If whatever that is being said makes some kind of conversation with you, gives you some kind of a feeling, your tune may be wrong initially, okay? But if the feeling is right, that right feeling will guide you to the right tune. I'm 101% sure about this. If you pursue it passionately and patiently, the feeling inside you is going to guide you to the right tune. It always does. Okay? I think that's a beautiful note to end this session on. Thank you so much for your patience. Today's session went rather long. Next week, we are going to start a new season called What's Sarega with MK. Here we are going to cover the theory of Indian classical music, okay? North Indian classical music. Well, Indian classical music roughly, but mostly focused on North Indian classical music. If you haven't shared this recording with everyone, too, if you haven't joined MKSM global group, we have activity happening there. And three, if you know friends who are just curious or want to know what is Indian classical music, for example, this is the pitch. If you do not know what is Purvanga, what is Uttaranga, if you do not know what Kali is, if you do not know what Khand is, or if you want to revise what they are, what Sarega with MK is for you every week, Wednesday, 9 p.m. Indian Standard Time. That is the pitch. Okay. Alright, I am signing off now. Have a wonderful rest of the week, a musical one. Homework, you know what they are. We are going to post them again. Until then, stay well. Bye.